Hello, viewers, and welcome to hopefully the finale to Bioshock Infinite. And last time, we made it to the bridge, and along the way, we killed Father Zachary Hale Comstock. And now that he is dead, now we have a new mission to go back to the statue of the statue that Elizabeth was in, apparently, the siphon that was mentioned in Comstock House, is the very device that prevents Elizabeth from opening tears to go wherever she wants. So, let's head over to the statue and destroy it.
Cage, what is that?
Now what?
What is she trying to tell us? Cage, I'm missing something.
They knew what was best for us.
Huh?
They said they knew what was coming next.
Oh boy.
Did you see this coming, old man?
Okay, we
did
gotta get ready.
Did you see this coming?
I think they mean to board us.
You ain't gonna place your daughter on the throne. We're gonna place her in our grave.
What? Elizabeth, what are you doing?
What are you doing?
We have to sing to him.
Sing to who? Elizabeth, stop it.
C-A-G-E.
Oh.
Music.
That's what the Lutessas were trying to say. Now, Songbird our side now. That's what the Lutessas were trying to tell us. They knew this was going to happen.
I need you to protect me. Will you do it? Will you do this for me? Just this one last thing. Go. Go, go, go! Booker, he'll help us. We can use him against the boss fleet. Rockets over there!
Right, where? And yeah, this fight is not going to be easy. Because now, this has became an escort
Booker,
fight.
Tell Songbird where to go.
We need this thing to make it to Monument Island.
And we want to save the Songbird for really bad things. They will throw literally everything to stop us to get to Monument Island. And this is why this is one considered one of the hardest parts in this game. The finale is the hardest part. I know, right? So here's what we have to do. We do have Songbird to help us. But Songbird will only come once we use him. He's on cooldown. And we're gonna use Songbird for only for some really tough enemies to deal. And this fight is brutal on 1999 mode. And we have to break a lot of... And here's a good reason why we need Songbird. Some enemies will... Some of the airships will have rocket barrages.
There's
we will have blimps. So we need to stop all the bullshit right away. So use Vigors, and if the thing is destroyed, game over. You have to start all over again.
That's all I have.
God, come on, Elizabeth, help me. I need some goddamn health.
Booker, Songbird's ready.
Okay, Songbird's ready. So yeah, we're good on that. Medkit.
You bet.
Gonna need some medkit. And some salt. There's some possession salt, some bottles of salt. Okay. Okay, I think it's... Okay, so... It is set in waves, so... Okay, I get the gists. Okay, that's... I think... I don't remember how many waves there are.
The streets were paved with gold.
Okay. Okay, I want to save Songbird for the next Lux coming in. And there's a good example. Yeah, they spawned the giant blimps from Think Manufacturing. So, if we want to destroy all the fox populi, send the Songbird. Order it to automatically destroy. Destroy the Zeppelin. Oh god, motorized Patriot.
I'm not ready. Here you go.
Thank you. Thanks. Thank you, Elizabeth. Switch. Spawn it in. Destroy the box populi. Come on. Force.
Oh no.
Come on.
The Zeppelin.
Thank you. Thank you, game. For being such a pain. 100% salt. Yeah, that takes care of the Zeppelin. Songbird.
Ready, Booker.
Okay, destroy the Zeppelin. Okay, time to break it. Shocky Chucky and Undertow. Very powerful combo. Oh, what? What's firing? Okay, there's a Rocketeer. Take him out with some possession. It's a one-hit kill. Let's get rid of those two a-holes. Alright, I am freaking out. Return to sender. And if you die, you still be able to respawn.
I can help you.
Oh god, yes, we've done. That was it. That's it. That's the entire. That's all the fight. That's the whole fight. So three rounds. And once you get into the third end of the third round, you're basically done. You are done. Whoo! Now, we made it. So let's get to the bow and finish this. And finish
Booker,
this
here.
Game.
What is it?
Look, you can use the songbird to bring the whole damn thing down. Destroy the siphon.
And that's what you want.
It's the only way we'll find the truth. About my finger, Comstock, everything.
All right. Let's do it. Order Songbird to destroy the siphon. Bird or the cage? There it goes. All that siphon energy. Terror energy.
Whistler! Elizabeth! The bird, Elizabeth! I lost control! He's coming!
No, he isn't.
Where is he? Where is he?
What the hell?
It's okay. It's all right. I'm here.
Elizabeth, I'm sorry. What is this place? Elizabeth?
It's a doorway. One of many. This way.
What do you mean it's a doorway? Where are you going?
Oh, come on. Yes, it's this way.
What Comstock said about your finger. Is there an answer here? Do you...
Down here!
Guess where we are. We're back in Rapture. And this is the entrance hallway in the first
here,
game. And now Songbird is now at the bottom of the sea. And this is definitely after the time the protagonist of the first game went through here. It could be some years after the events of that, of the first game. So, yeah. Now it's time for a lot of... Now we must enjoy the ending. And enjoy all the philosophy this will bring. So, yeah. We got a lot of talking, and this is mostly... basically a recreation of the very first game. We have the Gatherer's Garden, where we got our Electrobolt. The Great Chain is guided by our hands. And this is just Kevin Levine just being completely meta. So this is a lot of philosophy questions. And this is the entranceway where our first encounter of the Splicers was.
This is where we have to go.
Why? What is going on? Elizabeth, what do you mean this is a doorway?
I'll have to show you.
So, yeah. Let's activate the bathysphere.
Probably gonna regret this.
Oh, you might, Booker. And we're going through the reverse order of the intro of Bioshock. Going up
City
to the surface.
At the bottom of the ocean. Ridiculous.
Well, technically, it may be scientifically possible to build an underwater city, something similar to Rapture under the sea, but that's for to going through a video of explanation on that.
Look at that. Thousands of doors opening all at once. My God, they're beautiful. What,
the stars?
Come on. Come on, it's this way. Come on.
And what Elizabeth is implying, all the stars that we see up there, in her eyes, they're just thousands upon thousands upon thousands of doors to other realities of the multi-
Are you going to open it?
It's no good. Damn it. I thought once we were here, I could fully control it. I thought...
What is that?
It's a key.
Where did it come from?
It's always been there. I just couldn't see it.
Yep. And something similar. We're going to go through a bit of a meta-ness. Going through the same door.
See? Not stars. They're doors.
Doors to...
To everywhere. All that's left is the choosing.
Well, it doesn't entirely matter. Because we're on, basically on rails.
What are all these lighthouses? Why are we... Who are...
There are a million, million worlds. All different and... All similar. Constants and variables.
What?
There's always a lighthouse. There's always a man. There's always a city.
How do you know this?
I can see them through the doors. You, me, Columbia, Songbird. But sometimes, something's different. We have the same.
Constants and variables.
Yes.
And what Elizabeth is implying, yeah. This is just Kevin Levine being super meta, bringing up the ideas that, yeah, about the whole Bioshock series in general. We always see a lighthouse at the beginning of the game. Well, not in 2, technically, but from Bioshock 1 and Infinite, we always start at a lighthouse. It doesn't matter. There's always constants and variables in talking about the multiverse. The many worlds interpretation theory. There are, as a person, a scientist once says, there are thousands and thousands of possibilities. It doesn't matter, constants and variables. And if you want to know more about the whole multiverse theory, Rick and Morty goes through the ideas that Kevin Levine uses. For comedy, mostly. But the science is there. And Rick mostly does the same thing all the time. Interpretate every single lighthouse as a parallel universe. And there are billions upon billions upon billions beyond the infinite. There are infinite possibilities. It doesn't, and besides, whatever door you're going to choose, it doesn't really matter which lighthouse you're going to go into. You're stuck on rails, but... The idea there are billions and billions and billions infinite possibilities, it's completely nuts. Nuts beyond imagining. It doesn't really, if crazy. And let's just say an underwater city, Rapture, there might be an actual one on a different universe. Columbia? Could be beyond the many worlds interpretation theory. If proven, yeah, it's nuts.
Look.
It's us.
Not exactly. We swim in different oceans, but land on the same shore. It always starts with a lighthouse.
I don't understand.
We don't need to. It'll happen all the same.
Why?
Because it does. Because
Yes, it has. Yes, it will.
There are so many choices.
They all lead us to the same place. Where it started.
No one tells me where to go.
Booker. You've already been.
Well, so many infinite possibilities. But sadly, we're stuck on rails. You could go through any door you want, but you always end up at the same point in this. To carry on with the story, this game, every time we died, that's just another universe entirely, ones that we failed. But it's always the ones that would be correct and be able to succeed. Yeah, it's that multiverse of madness.
Wait a minute. I know this place. I was here 20 years ago, right after Wounded Knee. I was looking for...
Come on now, time's a-wasting.
Why were you here?
Are you ready to have your past erased? Are you ready to have your sins cleansed? Are you ready to be born again? Take my hand.
No. No, I don't want to.
You already did, didn't you?
May have to take the preacher's hand, and strangely enough, the preacher here is the very same, maybe the same preacher from the beginning of the game when we had to enter Columbia. Remember how we got into Columbia? We had to go through a baptism. And that means being careful not to drown the person. So, let's accept the baptism.
Are you ready to be born again?
I am.
Do you hate your sins?
I do.
Do you hate your wickedness?
Yes.
Do you want to clean the slate, leave behind all you were before, and be born again in the blood of the Lamb? Jesus, wash this man clean.
Wait.
Father, make him born again. Lord,
stop it.
What are you doing to it?
Get off me! Get off!
Son!
You didn't go through with it.
You think a dunk in the river's gonna change the things I've done? Let's get out of here. Hey, these doors of yours, they're all tears, right? Well, open one up. Open one up to Paris. I want to be shut of all this.
Not until we find Comstock.
Comstock's dead!
No. He was here. This way.
Well, it doesn't really matter if we kill what Elizabeth is implying. Comstock will always exist in the multiverse. The Comstock that we killed is just one out of billions and billions of infinite possibilities. There might always be a Comstock. And the way Booker was reacting, I guess when everything went gray, we had a bit of a flashback into Booker's history, and Booker did not take the baptism. So let's open the door.
And what of my debts?
Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt.
This is the man who hired me to find you.
Really?
Yes, the girl for the debt.
And this was the person who told us to go and get Elizabeth. And he just remembered it. And this is Robert Lutess, one of the Lutesses. So why was he here? And do you listen carefully? That music has been playing throughout our flashbacks. And we couldn't go through this door. The memory always cuts off. Now we're gonna see what's behind this door.
Wait, no, this is wrong. What is this? There was no baby. There was no baby, and if there was, I sure as hell wouldn't give it over to this guy.
Booker, you don't leave this room until you do.
Do it. Time is running short. Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt.
Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt. Funny, that sentence keeps cropping up, hasn't it? And we have to give up the baby to Robert Lutece. You see what's going on here at this point? This is a very good twist on what's going on. So, let's pick up the child. Our child.
Go ahead.
No.
You can wait as long as you want. Eventually, you'll give him what he wants.
How do you know all this?
I can see all the doors, and what's behind all the doors. And behind one of them, I see him.
Comstock.
Yep. Now, we have to give the baby to Robert Lutece. And this was mostly a flashback to what happened prior to all this.
What choice do I have?
The debt's paid. Mr. Comstock washes you of all your sins.
That was a flashback, and we didn't remember it until now. Wonder why we couldn't remember all of it. It was hints. If you pay attention.
Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt.
There was no baby. The deal was I go to Columbia to get you.
Booker, you're bleeding.
You're lying.
I remember what I remember.
Now we've upset him.
I don't expect this next bit will do much for his mood.
Come on.
And we're right back at the beginning of the game.
What are we doing here? Comstock's dead. We can just go on with our lives. You don't need
dead?
To...
You mean like Chen Lin? Like Lady Comstock? No. He is alive in a million, million worlds. It's not over because the Prophet is dead. It will only be over when he never even lived in the first place.
Remember what, remember back to what, Fitzroy said before she died. To get rid of a problem, you have to pull it up from the root. And we're basically doing what we're taking Fitzroy's advice. Remember, Comstock will always exist in infinite possibilities with the multiverse theory. It doesn't matter if you kill one. One Comstock is just like a speck of grain in the sand in the desert. Doesn't matter. Unless you get rid of all the Comstocks. Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt has a bit of a double meaning.
Hey. Hey, the deal's off, you hear me? The deal is off!
It's
give her back!
Hurry.
Give her back!
Fine, are you mad?
And now we're getting more flashbacks to what happened with the baby and Comstock. So apparently we changed our mind about the deal and tried to get our baby back.
Give her back, you son of a bitch!
It's ready! Go!
No!
Shut down the machine!
Shut
it down! Shut down the machine! Now do it!
Give me back my daughter! No!
And now it comes all full circle.
Anna! No. No.
So yeah, that's quite the plot twist.
Anna, I'm sorry.
So with that flashback, we finally get a lot of context on what's going on with... Remember Battleship Bay before Booker... Before Elizabeth saved Booker from drowning? He said, Anna. When I first played the game, this game, I thought Anna was Booker's wife. And it all makes sense now. And Anna, our Booker's daughter, lost her pinky as a baby. and Elizabeth lost her pinky. So Elizabeth, the person that we've been with in trying to get the girl to go, was our daughter all grown up. And also, there's one more detail that we forgot to mention. Now we have another context to the next scene.
She's gone, Booker.
Remember, A.D.?
Shared this room with your regret for almost 20 years. Until one day, a man came to you, offered you a chance at redemption. A chance for us to live together.
And now, basically, our last flashback. Remember how the hand was branded, Booker's hand was branded A.D.? A.D. stands for Anna DeWitt, our daughter, as a permanent reminder that we lost our daughter. And Comstock used that brand to inform the people about the false shepherd. Comstock knew that Booker would try to get it, get her, his daughter back. And now, how we get got into this mess in the beginning.
You suppose he branded himself as some sort of penance? Don't see the point. What's done is done. What's done will be done. I suppose the brand is his hair shirt, as he is ours.
Wipe away the debt. Here's the girl. Wipe away the debt.
See? He's starting to put his story together.
You're quite fond of this theory of yours.
He's manufacturing new memories from his old ones.
Well, the brain adapts.
I should know. I lived it.
Booker, wake up. Booker, wake up. This is where it started.
I sold you.
To your credit, you did try to weasel out of the deal.
This is all Comstock's fault. What if I went back? Killed him before he did any of this?
Things get set in motion.
How would one know how far back to go?
That's the only way to do it. Go back to when he was born, and I'll smother the son of a bitch in his crib.
And now the final pieces of our memory has come back. And now we know why Booker never remembered all of it. And now we're back at the beginning of the game. We come full circle. And now we know what to do. Kill Comstock before Comstock is ever born. Kill him before he grows up to be a man. Before he was a baby, kill a baby to prevent all of this. But there's one piece of advice you should be careful with. What we're doing is basically making a wish, right? So I would like to say this one little quote. Be careful what you wish for. You have to be very, very careful what you say when you make your wish. The monkey's paw might interpret things a little different. And one more detail. Magic always comes with a price. Are you willing, when you make that wish, are you willing to pay the price for what you want? And Booker wants Comstock to never be born. Let's see what happens when we go behind this door.
Are you sure this is what you want?
I have to. It's the only way to undo what I've done to you.
Oh, guess where we are!
Are you ready to be born again.
Why are we back here?
This isn't the same place, Booker.
Of course it is. I remember.
Wait. Are you ready to leave behind all that has gone before? Wipe the slate clean.
Who are you?
You chose to walk away, but in other oceans, you didn't. You took the baptism. You were born again as a different man. It all has to end. To have never started. Not just in this world, but in all of ours.
Smother him in the crab.
Smother. 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 Before the choice is made. Before you are reborn.
And what name shall you take, my son?
He's Zachary Comstock. He's Booker DeWitt.
No. I'm both.
And remember what happened to Zachary Hale Comstock? Died by drowning. Yep. The main villain of this game, Zachary Hale Comstock, was Booker if Booker took the baptism. And when we killed our... Well, technically, our Booker is not dead. It's complicated to explain the science of what just happened this scene. So from the way I can tell, and yeah, the achievements kick in, saying, yep, and that's the end of the game. That's Bioshock Infinite. And to interpret it that last moment, the way it was written, when I first played it, I thought Booker died from killing. In order, Booker had to die to make sure Comstock never lived. Never be born. Like I said, be careful what you wish for when you're making your wish. The monkey's paw effect twists the wish into something you didn't think of. And from the way the cutscene transpires, Booker strangely couldn't remember Elizabeth that moment. So I guess we kind of went to the moment when, to the root. Remember, we had to go back to the root and pull it from the root to make sure there is no Comstock. Comstock will never be able to be born. But that doesn't stop all the Comstocks. Only Comstocks who are born from through religion. There could be many Comstocks that can be born differently. That's the many worlds interpretation. Maybe Comstock doesn't become a prophet. It's food for thought. From the way it happened, that Booker who became Comstock is dead, and every of those Elizabeths were the ones that Comstock still exists. All the Columbia stuff are basically gone when you kill Comstock. All those Comstocks will never be born. No Comstock, no Columbia, no Elizabeth, no deal. No, nothing. And it's, and yeah, there is like a end cutscene that brings up, yeah, the Comstock, the Booker we know, technically does live on. He does live. And yeah. That's the end of the game, so I can't show the cutscene, but I'll probably add it and put into context on what that meant. The Comstock we've been playing as is still alive, but in a different universe. Different alternative universe. And he's happy, and he got to keep Anna. Anna will never be sold to Comstock ever again. So what happens to the Elizabeth we've been playing with? Well, she's went off somewhere, and the next time we ever play Bioshock Infinite, we will be tackling The Burial at Sea, Episode 1 and Episode 2, if you want to vote on if we should continue that story. Burial at Sea, it's its own story, and the first part has some interesting ideas. As we return to Rapture, and we play a different Booker DeWitt. Part 2 is mostly a tie-in to the first game in subtle ways. I don't know if Bioshock 1 is Burial at Sea Episode 2 is basically retconning a few ideas from Bioshock 1 to tie it into Infinite's story. So yeah, that was Bioshock Infinite, and yeah, still love it. And you should totally get the collection for all three games. So, I'll see you on the next Let's Play. And if you guys want to vote on doing Burial at Sea, I will do Burial at Sea. And maybe if you guys want to vote again, I could possibly redo the first Bioshock 1 and Bioshock 2 and make it more better than my past version. So until then, have a good day, and I will see you on the next Let's Play. So until then, have a fun day, and bye for now.